We got a young team. Our guys, if they start thinking about anything else, you know, we can't keep focused on what we need to keep focused on the way it is. If they start looking ahead, you know, we really got problems. So, you know, I tried to tell them, fellas, we can't change what's happened. We're 9-4. It is what it is. The only thing we can work about is Saturday. And it's hard to do with everybody writing stuff, telling them what they should be thinking and what they should be, you know. But you know, I try to, again, just keep things simple and day-to-day. And I hope they're worried about practice here at 2 o'clock and trying to get a little better at practice and then trying to play as hard as we can tomorrow. I like Oregon State's team. They're experienced. Thompson brothers, Trey, I mean, they've got a good team, you know, and they haven't played as well as they should, you know, or they wanted to, I'm sure. You know, they lost four games by a total of 16 points, you know, 2 3-pointers, 4-pointer, 6-pointer, if my math is right, but, you know, they've lost four really close games. It could have went either way. So I'm sure they're sitting there going, man, you know, we're that close. And so, you know, everybody in the league, kind of up and down. There's no consistency. I think the only way you get consistent is try to get better each and every day, and I hope that's what our team's focused on.
Does it help, though, that there isn't a team out there that you can literally say that they're the team to beat? Like, it seems like it's completely wide open, and that if you guys can lock in...
No, I don't know. I haven't thought about it, man. All I'm worried about is just trying to get our team better. You know, and that's all of us. You know, we haven't done a good enough job. Our players haven't done a good enough job. Can't correct that. We just got to move forward and try to get better.
They're bigs. Kelly and then with Rice Epic now being back, but against Wooten and Bull, kind of an interesting matchup inside. But now you figure, I mean, that's going to be where they're looking to go with kind of having, you know, a shot blocker and kind of a more physical guy inside than maybe you guys have.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think they'll go away from their offensive strengths. You know, their strengths are still Thompson brothers, which, right? You know, I mean, that's their strength. So, you know, I don't think they'll change too much offensively what they're looking to do. Defensively, you know, they've done a good job inside, and you know, we're just, you know, we're not going to change too much the way we do it. Just, you don't have Bowl to play through, so we're going to have to be a little bit more perimeter oriented. But it won't change too much.
Have you ever experienced this as coach before, just the whole situation with Bull and seeing what's best for a player and whether or not he will decide to stay or go and doing that?
Well, I haven't had too many guys that were 21-10. Guys don't come around every day, but, you know, as a coach, teacher, you just want what's best for your guys. And like I said, Bull was a lot of fun to work, but that's selfishly, that's the thing I'm gonna miss, is just I enjoy going to work and going to practice with him every day. And so, you know, it is unusual, but again, you know, we've had some foot problems here, and I just sorry to see it, you know, only be 9 games, because I was really looking forward to growing as a coach and growing, having him grow as a player, you know, throughout the year.
Anything about that situation make you reassess at all recruiting the quote-unquote one-and-done type guys? Because if you do have a bad break, you could end up having a break.
You know, it's, you want players that want to be here and you want them to be the most talented that they can be. You know, when we recruited Jordan Bell, and we never thought he'd be out of here early, and Dylan Brooks really not, you know, and Tyler maybe, you know, but would you change? No, you'd still go get him. And Troy was a one and done, and it, you know, being drafted 15th, it really worked out for him. Did we have the season we wanted last year? No, you know, we were 3 or 4 games off where we wanted to be. And so, you know, it's not an easy question to answer. But, you know, we recruited Bowl and definitely wanted to turn him down, you know, and it wouldn't change my mind if another talented player wanted to come in. But we want players to realistically assess where they're at, you know, and otherwise it can be hard to work with them, you know. And but if they have faith in you as a coach, you know, then they'll work to get better. Good players want to get better. You know, good players want to be disciplined. If a coach and a player get to, you know, get along great, it probably means the coach isn't pushing them enough. Because if you're pushing them, there's going to be a little conflict somewhere. So, you know, you want guys that want that conflict, that want to be pushed. And you know, fortunately over the years, and I've had a lot of them, you know, and that's what makes coaching fun. And Bolt wanted to be pushed. You know, he, you know, I challenged him. He probably had three or four really bad practices, and I'd get on him, and the next day he'd come back and push himself, and, you know. So, yeah, he was fun to work with, and, you know, that conflict, like I said, when I pushed him, he wanted to get better, and that's why I was excited about working with him.